Do you want a nugget of truth to start out your day? If so, you have come to the right place. Here we give you a devotional power boost to the beginning of your day and pray that God will bless you as He sees you on your way.
Welcome, and so glad you have joined us for yet another daily devotional on Praying with a Mission. I am reading from Amazing Answers to Big Bible Questions. Today we are going to be studying, how can I share the truth about God with my friends? Our Bible verse today is Proverbs 17, verses 17. A friend loves at all times. First, let's discuss what we shouldn't do when sharing our faith. People don't respond to argument. When hearts are proud and stubborn, we dig in and fight, no matter what creative language arguments are presented. So don't preach at people. Remember, you were once in their position. See Ephesians 2, verses 13. And that is so true. Like, if we come and approach someone and be like, oh, you know, you're supposed to be doing this and this is how it is and everything, then that is not going to be an encouragement to them. It's going to be pushing them away instead of bringing them closer to Christ and what He has for them. And, you know, if we do know things that we feel like they should know, I think it's very important to give it in little bits here and there. You know, God never forced a whole bunch of stuff down us. And in fact, when He talked about sharing things in the Bible, when He shared things in the Bible, He didn't tell it in the whole story right there. He shared it in parables. And the parables had steps, lessons, and things we could learn from them. And so as we find people that we want to share God to, and we want to spread the good news, we should do it in little snippets so that they're going to be hungry to come back and want to know more. If we feed it and force it, so to speak, down their throats all at once, they're going to be trying to still swallow and not really wanting to learn anything else because of the experience we just gave them. So let's keep that in mind. And also, as we continue to read on, let's really take to heart what the writer is trying to bring across. There are three specific things we can do to share God's love with those we care about. Be a friend and listen. Then if they are open to it, share information. The Bible says, let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one. Colossians 4, verses 6. It's a good idea to pray, asking the Holy Spirit to guide you and help you know what to speak and what to say. Share with your friends what God has done for you personally. How has a relationship with Him changed your life for the better? And I think this is another way in which we can take it as an opportunity to share what God has done for us. Sharing to our friends and family, perhaps, how God has helped you in your relationship with Him, the blessings that He's giving you through that relationship. Yes, explaining to them that it's not all peaches and cream, but that the journey along the way becomes better as we grow closer to Christ. And just sharing those blessings alone will plant a seed in their heart to maybe want to know God more, maybe want to have that same relationship with Christ as you do. And that's really where the Lord takes over after you've planted that seed, and He nurtures it and He helps it to grow into a beautiful flower. So as we continue listening to what the writer has to say, consider doing that with your friends and family, and pray the Lord helps you to know exactly the right words and how to bring it across to them. That can make a real impact on someone's thinking. Sometimes sharing a book or a DVD works well, especially with people who are argumentative. Be a good example. You do not want to be unchristlike and get angry at your friends if they disagree with you. That's not the way Jesus would win them over. But you can set an example in the way you live. If love is your motivation in life, people will notice. In all things, show yourself to be Patreon of good works. Use sound speech that cannot be condemned, that one who is appointed may be ashamed, having nothing evil to say with you. Titus 2, verses 6 and 8. Pray for your friends continually and patiently. Remember, the effective, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. James 5, verses 6. And here I have to jump in really quickly and say that prayer is powerful. I have been an eyewitness to praying for family, for friends,
and watching God step in, and do amazing things, change their lives, help them to grow closer to Christ, saving their lives from dangerous instances, and so much more. Prayer is powerful, guys. And also, if we pray for someone else, it can intervene through the power of the Holy Spirit in their lives and also be a bigger blessing to them, depending on what situation they're in and their spiritual walk and growth with Christ. As we read on, we can't see things the way God does, and sometimes it takes months or years for Him to reach those who we love. Trust that He wants to save your friends even more than you do. Don't give up. Keep on praying.
If you have enjoyed this devotional, then please look around and find the like button and give it a friendly tap on the shoulder. Put a comment down there and tell me which part of this devotional was your favorite, which part you got out a good nugget that you can take throughout the day, and just consider subscribing, because the more the merrier, and you know, God's family is not a small family. So if you would love to join us in this adventure of praying with a mission, check out what we have below. There are many other options, and see you around.